Stayallday.com.
The topic is the long run of life. And if you didn't know, I'm getting ready to run a marathon. Well, it ain't really that close, still about 6 months away. I'm running a marathon in January in Miami. It's 26.2 miles, so this is a perfect topic for it. You just finished yoga. Shout out to all the yogis out there, people doing yoga. I'm gonna give you 3 tips today about the long run of life, because life is, I know y'all have heard the phrase life is short, but life can also be long. Life is long. A year is a long time. 5 years, 10 years, 20 years is a long time. So if you watching this and you 25, 25 years is a long time. I mean, imagine if you was in jail for 25 years. That's a long time. All right, time can go long. So in life, you got to play the long run. You got to play the long game. Somebody asked me how much is something. Send me a snap at Dre Baldwin. I'll send you the link where you can find it. But it's at hoophandbook.com. Send me a snap at Dre Baldwin. I'll tell you about that. But in life, you always need to keep your mind on the long game. Yes, there are times where you need to make short game plays, but often you need to make long game plays. And many times people can't see past the next day, the next hour, the next paycheck, and they make mistakes that cost them in the long run because all they're thinking about is the short run. So I'm gonna give you 3 things you need to keep in mind for the long run and anything you do in life. Number one thing is you gotta play the long game. Play the long game. What that means is you might do something today or this week or this year that seems to not be a problem for you. You know in the back of your mind that this is not a smart thing to do for the long run of your life, but you do it anyway because it feels good, because it gives you that instant gratification. But understand, over the next 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, you keep taking those same actions, eventually you're going to have to pay for those. If you know anybody who got cancer from smoking, cancer from maybe they got something in their liver from drinking a lot or from doing any type of drugs or from not taking care of their bodies, not putting the right food in their bodies. By the time they get to 50, 60 years old, they start to get sick. They got all these medical bills. They can't even take care of themselves anymore. That's not because they did something when they was 52 or they did something when they was 63. That's something that they did when they was the same age that you are right now. And then over the long run, it starts to catch up to them and now they can't do anything about it. Now it's irreversible. They don't have the power. They don't have the energy, the physical energy to undo the stuff that they did to themselves because they were playing a short game. They're playing a short game of instant gratification. The better you can put off instant gratification in life, all of you out there, I don't care how old you are, the better you are putting off instant gratification. That's basically the phrase we use for that is discipline. Being able to put off that instant gratification of sleeping an extra hour, instant gratification of eating the food you know you're not supposed to eat, the instant gratification of not going to the gym on the days that you don't feel like it. When you can put that off and do the stuff you need to do when you're supposed to do it, in the long run, you will see results. The challenge people have with that is that you can't see the results in the moment. That's why most people don't do it. Number two thing as far as winning the long run in life is lose battles but win the war. Lose the battle but win the war, which means sometimes in life, I mean all the time in life, we all have situations that don't go the way that we want them to go in the short term, but we can still be successful in the long run. For example, you could try out for the basketball team in 9th grade or 10th grade or 12th grade and not make it, but you could still end up playing ball in college. Or maybe you don't do that well playing in college, but you end up making it to the pros. Or maybe you don't get a lot of customers with the first business you start, but eventually you start a business that makes $1 million a month. Or maybe you don't get the girl that you was trying to date, but you end up, because of that, meeting another girl who was even better than that girl, and you end up marrying the better girl because you didn't get the first girl. So, and sometimes another person, maybe you're dealing with another person you're competing with and they beat you in some competition, or they get one up on you on something, and maybe they talking shit to you, they laughing at you, they ridicule you, and you feel down in the moment, but in the long run you end up outdoing that person by so much that you don't even remember that situation even happened. So understand that in the short term, over the course of a week, a day, a month, some things may happen that don't necessarily go your way, but that's okay. You can lose battles in life. Just make sure you win the overall war. It's just like in a real war, there are going to be hundreds of battles. One side don't have to win every single battle to win the whole war. Y'all understand that. Number three thing is this. You make slow and steady progress. You must get better every single day. To win in the long run, you got to make slow, small improvements every day. And again, the thing about this goes right back to instant gratification. A lot of people don't want to put in the work because they can't see the results that day. They're like, all right, well, I've been working out for a month. I ain't lose no weight, so no, this trainer is not worth the money. Or I've been reading these books every day for the last 6 months, but I don't feel like I'm any smarter. I don't feel like I'm making any more money. I don't feel like I'm getting any better in life, so I'm not reading no books no more. This is what most people do. Or they say, you know, I've been eating spinach and salads and drinking water every day for the last 3 months, but I'm still out of shape and I still don't have the energy that I want to have, so I'm going to go right back to eating fried chicken and potato chips and candy every single day because they don't see the immediate results. All you need to do is a phrase y'all heard before. It's called win the day. Win the day means this. Every single day, you need to decide, what's one thing I can do today that will make this day a success? But it needs to be something that moves you closer to whatever your ultimate goals are. What's one thing I can do today that will make it a success? That might be go walk 1 mile for exercise. That might be eat a bag of spinach. That might be don't eat that bag of potato chips that's in the pantry. It might be throw the potato chips in the trash can. It might be let me read that book so I can figure out how I can start this business. It might be let me call that college and find out how much it's going to cost me to go there for a semester or how many credits I need so I can get my degree. You got to figure out one thing every single day, at least one thing every single day that gets you closer to whatever your ultimate goal is. You got to make slow and steady progress so you can win that day. You don't have to win all of life in one day, everybody. You don't have to make $1 billion in one day. But listen, if you can start making 10 today, you can make 10 tomorrow, 10, maybe you start to get up to 12, then 20, then 2,000, then 2 million. Eventually, maybe you can get to that point, again, figuratively speaking. But you got to start somewhere. If you never ran even a mile before, don't try to run a marathon the first day. Just walk around the block one day until you can walk around the block without losing your breath, then try jogging around the block. Then jog a half a mile, then jog 2 miles, then go 5, then try to run a little bit faster. Then eventually you'll get to that point, but you got to make slow and steady progress. Don't try to win all of life in one day. Just like they say in basketball, if your team's down 10, ain't no 10-point shots. You know, you can only do it twos and threes at a time. Can't make a 10-point shot to come back. You got to score, get the ball back, score, get the ball back. So you got to make slow and steady progress. So let me recap, and I'm going to take questions, everybody. This is Dre Baldwin for those who came in during the stream. Point number one, this is about winning the long run of life. Number one is play the long game, which means don't make all your decisions based on instant gratification, feeling good in the moment. Make decisions that will help you in the long run as well, but maybe not feel that great in the moment when you do it. Number two, lose battles but win the war. Just because things don't work out for you immediately, that's okay. You can still get the end game result, even if you don't get all the results today. And number three is get better every single day. Slow and steady progress. Always improve slowly on everything that you're doing. Figure out what's one thing you can do to get you closer to your goal every day and make sure you get it done. So let me take questions. This is Dre All Day. I'm also known as Dre Baldwin. For those who don't know me, my Snapchat is at Dre Baldwin. My Instagram, same thing. If y'all got questions, go ahead and post it. How do I get jacked? You got to win the day. Slowly every single day. Go to the gym. Go find somebody who's already jacked. Ask them what they did and then just start doing what they said they did to start from zero. Make sure they know what they're talking about. Have I heard of the theory of 1%? I don't know. Tell me what it is. Maybe I've heard of it by a different name. What if they say steroids? Then, hey, you got to decide. Use your brain and figure out if that's something you want to do. Where should I go running if I run around a block? I get shot, I'm in Chicago. All right, well, hey, go to the gym. Treadmills. All right, get this guy out of here. Can I take any questions? This is Dre All Day. There are a lot of temptations. So, is that your excuse? I mean, I know there are a lot of temptations. So if you go out and fuck your life up because you succumb to the temptation, is that what you're going to tell the doctor? Is that what you're going to tell your family? Is that what you're going to tell your kids? You know, kids, you know, I would have made a better life for you, but there were so many temptations. I just couldn't do it. Sorry. Sorry, son. You're going to have to figure it out on your own. Is that what you're going to say? Can I take any questions? Any questions? I'm going to take a minute or two, wait for anybody to come through with any questions y'all got. My Snapchat is at Dre Baldwin. That's where you can find me during the day. I do answer questions on Snap, as long as it's a good question. My website is called DreAllDay.com. You get my first book for free. What's going on for Basketball 6? You're welcome. You have a good day, too. All right, everybody, we wrapping this one up. I told y'all where y'all can find me, DreAllDay.com. If you listen to podcasts, my podcast is called Work On Your Game. And my Snap at Dre Baldwin. We out of here. If you're on Snapchat, hit me on the Snap. My Snap name is at Dre Baldwin. You already know how that works. And I got a podcast, if you didn't know. It is called Work On Your Game. It is an everyday podcast where I talk about getting yourself into the right mindset, that bulletproof mindset, getting yourself seen, heard, known, getting the exposure you want, and making things happen in your life instead of waiting for things to happen to or for you. Subscribe to that podcast when you're on iTunes, SoundCloud, and Stitcher. Make sure you check it every single day. Make sure you're subscribed so you catch the heat. Work on your game.